concept. If you want to leave earlier, you are going to be asked for some feedback in order for us to become better. This whole concert is being filmed right now, and it's being streamed online on Facebook. It's going to be projected tomorrow on this room. So if you have a problem with being filmed, yes, this is an option. Enjoy.
Something simple and physical, we can start communicating a little bit. And I would like us to close our eyes, if possible. And let's focus on our weight. How do you feel the sense of gravity? Where is your weight? Is it more in front, more back, more in your feet? And just move a little bit your weight. Play a little bit. And check a little bit your limitations. Balance, or do you think that you will lose your balance? And go back to the center. And imagine that a really small earthquake starts to happen. And let the shake happen to the world. Without opening our eyes, without raising our hands, and try to imagine how we look from above. If you could see us from the ceiling, let the air go out, exhale from the nose, and the earthquake becomes bigger and stronger. Thank you. Listen carefully. The audience is your instrument.
So Dissonance.
Played in order to practically understand how we are generally instrumentalized. Prepare the audience with concepts, questions, and movements as a way to explore the dissonance that exists between the individual narcissism that capitalism promotes and our social capacity, between how we conceive ourselves as free individuals with agency and the way that we are socially determined by capitalist relations, technology, and ideology. Reflect on the I-we relation while defining social dissonance. Help the collective subject to emerge.
There, I see it. You see, I have a huge nose. I always felt like that. I always felt that my nose is too much for my face. You know, like exceeds a little bit. It's kind of strange. Should have been a little bit like that. And I have also another mark in my body, which is in my back. It's a black hole. This is how I call it. It's a black mark. I used to feel very, very ashamed of this.
So sexy body. When I was a teenager, I was strong with arms that I didn't have actually. Oops. But I would be a liar if I would say now that it's a negative thing about me. I can show you. But there is something that it's not so okay. I have these stretch marks on my hips. You see? This is not so okay.
Kabul.
Hans.
Okay, I feel Hans. My back is my foot.
But
can you go to the light?
I have funny feet. They're far too big for a girl.
Oh, my feet, they're too big for a girl. They're size 42. I can never find pretty shoes.
Can you wear my shoes?
I don't know.
You're seven to home.
What the fit?
I guess the rest of you feel that you are perfect.
I'd rather like to ask something. Who told you that you are beautiful?
Our society does. They don't make nice girl shoes in 42.
Come on, it doesn't work. It's not funny like that.
I think it's a strange question. Why should I be unhappy with myself?
Talk happy, tell things that not make you comfortable.
But I'm having fun.
Yeah, that's funny. It's to feel you comfortable all the time.
No, I feel fun.
Thank you. Nice hands, have nice boots, they're not bad, you know what it's about that.
I decided not to make these comments about my own body.
Yeah, that's the performance, but you're okay with the others, nothing?
Do you believe that this is common?
No.
So why do you have a problem with other people expressing it?
I don't have a problem with other people expressing it.
Okay.
Not at all.
But you know, there is something in vulnerability that makes us even more honest and sharp.
Attractive or
male.
environment
changes, and your inner circles change, the more than you would tell a stranger in the end.
I don't understand the
oh,
answer.
The live stream is blocking the intimacy that I think you're trying to build.
Why?
Because someone's watching me who I can't watch back.
How many people are watching actually?
Three.
The other.
Hi, others.
Can you tell us something about yourself? Two people.
Two people, no, yeah.
Mavromati Elena, can you tell us something about you? Can you write a comment? Hello. No, someone else says hello to you. Object, subject. To be accurate, says hello. And the other person that watches? Do you feel better?
No, because it's also going to be online after we're gone. So the notion of the audience seeing this, hearing us talk about vulnerabilities to strangers, is already a vulnerable state to be in.
Why? What is at stake?
What is at stake?
Yeah.
If I enjoy the rest of this evening.
Enjoy?
Yeah. Well, not just this performance, but, you know, talking about stuff that you don't want to talk about initially without having a prompt can put you in a state of just not enjoying the rest of the evening.
Ask a question. Why did you decide to focus on physical imperfections to connect through vulnerability? Why the physical aspect?
Is this about enjoyment?
What?
Is this about enjoyment?
Oh, I guess this is a question for... What? No, yeah. He just asked something.
First, her question, I think.
Okay, so here it says the individual narcissism that capitalism promotes. Don't you think that our appearance is connected to our individual narcissism? I think it's an aspect.
Yeah.
So that's why I'm asking why you made the choice to focus on that aspect. I don't know who I should address this question to, you, or maybe even you. Or maybe people at home.
Because I believe that these parts of the body that don't go well or they're not unified in me somehow give me a satisfaction.
Sorry?
A satisfaction. Is something pleasurable to talk about, talking about them, and I don't know why.
Is it something that you could have with aspects of your personality? Do you think we can have access to your personalities, your inner selves, within an hour?
Yes.
Tell us about you.
Well, before, can I interrupt you a little bit?
Sure.
Why are you sitting there?
Because I don't want to be filled with violence.
Yes, but you're not participating.
I'm participating because I'm listening.
No, you're watching us.
Yeah, but I'm also talking with you.
Now?
Now, yes. But I didn't like the fact that you kind of objectified
Yeah. Filming objectifies people.
Could we all face towards you? Because now we are excluding you, and maybe this way we will be more connected. Maybe you will film the others. Because I don't like them.
So I don't understand the fact that you use the camera at all, because it I don't know if you want to make a kind of actually it's I don't like this interaction. Could you stop it? So this is like I don't like it. Is that a problem for you that I don't like it?
We want to know why.
But you don't need to film me because you want to know why. It doesn't make sense to be cooperative, kind of communicative.
She doesn't want to be filmed.
And he wants to go.
He wants to
leave the space.
To some things you cannot have access, but to some things you can have access, so your traces on the internet are not lost. And for me, that's a problem.
Yeah.
Because I cannot
hide
or say I want that to be linked to my person. So I don't know if that
you don't want. How much do you follow technology in general? Do you have a Google account? Facebook.
Yes, sure. I know there is a lot of things I don't really commit
control.
And control. I don't really like it, but I have to because I kind of.
But your presence in a performance for an hour, this is what you really don't want to be connected with here. Why?
And it has already been done. I mean, like
yeah.
If
yeah,
you
but
were
but
for
why?
1 minute, now you are.
We're trying to figure out why being in a performance online is so unbearable. Please, we can all compare to
just accept that she doesn't like to and stop it.
Yeah.
In her case.
We can talk about that, so we can talk about
it. We can continue with it.
Is it fair for
yes,
all
I think.
Of us
that yes.
We engage in being here?
For me it's no problem. If she doesn't want to, that's okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's not about what's fair and what's not. It's just that this project is also a research.
Yeah.
So it's good for us to have something against.
Yeah. But now that you all said that you don't feel bad about it?
The voice? You can't talk about the voice?
With
the voice.
With your voice, you can participate by voice.
Yes, yes. Well, I'm in the film now anyway.
I think if she has no problem with her voice, it's okay. It's all linked. But we have an impact.
So
the voice.
The voice.
So you want the privileged position.
Our thoughts is okay, but it's not okay.
You can film me now, okay?
Now I can? Okay.
Then not so directly, please.
You see, my voice, her voice, I mean, from what I understood, it's okay for your voice to be filmed, but not your physical
presence. I don't know. I don't know if you, in the beginning, did you make an introduction who everybody is or why they are, like, participating? Like, how is it to be, like, part of a group or just a group and we are, like, following you, your instructions or your instructions? I think it's kind of, for me, it feels very uncomfortable because I don't know what is going on and I understand the thing with the experiment, but maybe I'm not that in that relaxed mode or something open, and I think it's very confrontational what you are doing. So.
Do you think
that I don't want to talk about that?
Why do you stay?
She's not alone.
I don't think they're going to kick you to the ground if you open the door.
What?
I think you can open the door and walk out if you want to.
Yes, now I want to stay. I'm interested.
But he wants to
leave. I'm sorry for the...
Yeah, but don't worry, but he wants to leave and he can't leave.
Yes, I am.
No, he can.
But can I leave?
Yes, goodbye.
Yes, thank you. This,
but don't
this
so
is
angry.
The freedom when you can leave when you want.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, goodbye.
What do you want to
do? He is his freedom.
Yes, but still. Well, for me, this is freedom. I can link everywhere. I can link. Yes.
Okay, so but we all know we can live if we want. Do you feel free?
From?
Generally?
In our lives?
Yeah, right now, let's say.
Right now.
This is about Freedom Cop.
About freedom?
Freedom Cop.
Freedom Cop?
Yeah.
Corporate,
Freedom Cop.
Cooperative.
Cooperative, yeah.
Ah, Freedom Cop.
But do you think you've created conditions to get that?
Of course. Since you can leave?
Yeah.
That's what he said.
Yeah, but that was because the group intervened.
Can you think of some conditions in which you could pray?
Well, I mean, I chose to be here, so in that sense, the notion of freedom means having the right to your own body and to do with it, where you go where, however you want. So I have that freedom, and I have that freedom here. You can't take it away from me because you're not a state.
Sorry?
You're not a state, you're not a political apparatus that can take away my rights. So.
Political states are the only ones that have power?
No, I'm saying that the only ones who can take away my rights. You can't take away my rights.
We can't take away your rights inside this room.
Well, no. You can try.
You can have a big fight.
So, what do you think this performance, this concert is about? Does anyone have any idea or...?
I just know you made us feel very uncomfortable in a very short amount of time because we were like all in a circle and we were all feeling comfortable and we were all trying to open and to relax, and then like kind of this, you focus on one person and you make everyone focus her, for example, and then we were like I don't know, in a very weird position, like having, because I was already facing her, so I was like automatically facing her as well, but I didn't want to, because she didn't want to be faced, and that made me feel really uncomfortable. That actually made me want to leave as well. But I didn't want to leave, because that would be just rude, like having like this one person in an uncomfortable position. And then
yeah, I asked her to leave, and she didn't.
I don't know, are you comfortable? I feel very uncomfortable in this room.
No, but that's the final thing, it's the first step. If you, for me, like, see that went out, it was very funny because the man who went out, he was into the performance more than the other that just there, because he really getting to do that, like, he felt hungry and these things. But it's fun, it's just the way communication. Now it's like that. And now I'm traveling because in the first step I thought it was more fun than that. Now, like, now I have lose that. After that, somebody could go out, okay, everything is to the question. It's flat, yeah. I think that if we continue like before, it would be more nice.
But in the title of the piece, it says socialism. So it's about this. It's about having that friction.
My question is about the camera. They are the only that they use it. But
yeah,
if we take, can use it outside, but
yeah,
you can try.
Yeah.
It's a powerful thing.
Yeah.
But I think the only reason that it became uncomfortable is because of these three people. Because we were here, we were quite fun, and we were asking questions. And at some point, they did not get answered. It was focused on the lady over there, it was focused on the man who wanted to leave, and this was all orchestrated by these three performers.
Four
persons there.
Now you all feel comfortable? Sorry?
Actually, six. Because the guards as well.
No, waiting for you, invigilating.
Yeah, I get it, but when he wanted to leave, you stopped him.
Yeah. Yeah, because there's a rule.
Yeah, which
and
they
he
said.
He didn't want to play by the rule.
But they said that rule didn't apply to him.
Yes, but we said to you and you engaged to that.
Good point.
I mean, if you're here now, you have consented to the rule.
So the research, what's it supposed to lead to? What's the research supposed to lead to?
We have seen the hungerless certified days with your life.
So you didn't hate it.
Doesn't research start with a question?
There is a basic main question that produces all these things, all mm-hmm. these thoughts.
Mm-hmm. What's the method? Can you say something to your method?
I would say that we are part of the research.
I can say that today I noticed how, okay, these were techniques we used in order to do what you got actually, to create this awkwardness. And I see though this persistence of the self as a very structured.
Maybe she should film as you talk.
Yes. Okay, good. Do that. This persistence of the self while we're trying to, we give the space, we think we give the space
for you to go outside the tomato pilot. And there is a very strong persistence to what you are, what you feel, what you... And my comment is just that I find it impossible to create something collective throughout the individual. And the only collective things we have done until now are circles, rituals, and songs. Like non-verbal communication.
They much. They much, I'm saying. They much of ourselves, of our body, of our face.
To me, this is this having been filmed and seeing my own image, you know, projected to everybody is a very uncomfortable thing. I see when it happens, you know, I see myself and I say, do I look like that? My eyes are a little bit uneven, aren't they? Or I have a choppy waist, you know. And yeah, what are these expressions? Are they mine? I always do like that. I don't know why. Maybe, yeah. And maybe it's my problem, but I see that the whole room was in great tension when you all saw your faces projected on this big wall. It created tension, and actually except for you maybe, I'm not saying that this is the rule for everybody, but there was some tension in the room and you could feel it, I could feel it. There was an uncomfortable state for many of us. So the question is why? I mean, of course, you thought you have a bigger feet, and you thought that these marks make you feel you're uncomfortable with these marks, or you thought you have a hunched back, which is totally paranoid to me.
My daughter told that.
Yes, okay, but it's not obvious, okay? And yes, what are the social reasons for that? This is the question. But, I mean, what are the social reasons for our being in tension, being uncomfortable with that, or with being filled generally?
But I think, okay, you could call the answers because that's it's just unfamiliar for somebody to see himself in a big screen. Perhaps if you are an actor, you have these things in the big screen. I'm not talking about the small screen.
I think it has to do with what we consider to be real and what fictional. And this little distinction, I think, is generating this fear we have for each other. Because everything we filmed was not something that we created, it was already there. We did not create something new that did not exist. But at the same time, we're all afraid that this little part of ourselves is going to be exploited somehow. I think maybe this is the reason.
Well, if I can respond, to be honest, I lied and I tried to break open the exercise because you were giving an example and you were lifting up your shirt, showing a part of your body, which is a very specific decision to do and to show your vulnerability. And then she responded with her feet and he responded with a piece of his back. So choosing a specific part of your body is something that you started. That was your choice to direct us that way, to focus on body parts. And I just didn't understand that decision related to the research question that you posed in the beginning. I thought that this could be bigger or different. And actually, when you want to engage everyone as themselves and in a very vulnerable way, in a personal way, then I think the answer should come from themselves and not be a response to your example. So I could have chosen a body part, for sure. But I would be responding to you. I would be like you and not like me. So how does that help you? How does it help you?
It doesn't help us, right? It's exactly the opposite of what we're trying to do.
Yeah. And I think that is what was happening when you gave the example with all the body parts.
Super confident mood, but we are not aware of the group needs and the group dynamic and the fact that the rest of the people are not so they cannot get so easily with this kind of situations. So I feel that there is already happening a gap between our own limitations, because we are doing this every day, and the audience's limitations. And limitations, that's exactly the good word, the right word, I would say. How much we are prepared and you are not for what we are doing.
Do you think that maybe, so you are prepared, you know what you're going to say, you're standing in the line, you're telling me about your stretch marks, you show us a part of the rest.
Everything is a response to something else.
Yeah.
We don't live in an empty space.
Everything
is a response to an external action. Every action, every thought is a response.
So it means that what you said about doing something by yourself does not exist.
Okay.
This was one way. We suggest, we follow. Maybe you would suggest that too.